Okay, thank you for the instruction. Since this is a last talk, so I try to finish my talk as soon as possible so everybody can have action. Okay, so I'm Shifu from Shanghai Tech University. Actually, I graduated from UCLA on the Professor Kevin's group, so today I'm going to share with you our groups at UCLA and also Shanghai Tech's recent progress regarding the electric TI and their cable structures. So here's the outline of my talk. So first I will try to explain how we managed to combine the magnetic order with the TI and realize the quantum moments effect and its related phenomena. And then I will share with you our recent progress regarding the magnetic TI-based angle structures and finally come with the conclusion and the closing it. So since everybody here knows that TI is a very promising material because of its unique surface state, so I'm going to just be short on this page. I just emphasize that because the surface state has a unique spin moment locking mechanism. So this provides us with the very effective way to manipulate the electron spin through electrical method. And at UCLA, we have been using the molecular beam and taxi to prepare such TSM fields in the past 7 years. And here I just show one example of the TM picture of one type of TI grown on the gallium arsenide substrate. And you can see the interface is atomically sharp. And from the zooming picture, we can clearly see the highly ordered layered structure of the TI thin film. Okay, and after the thin film grows, we first did some standard device fabrication and compare with conventional silicon-based device. The TI has a much higher carrier mobility, which enables us to observe the quantum Hall effect. And also with some gate tuning, we were able to tune the Fermi level across the derived point and observe the so-called ambipolar effect. But all of this are just regarding the TI itself. In addition to the spin-orbital coupling, actually we know in nature that the magnetic momentum can also be used to manipulate the spin. So our idea is trying to combine these two effects together in such a way we may have a better spin controllability in the magnetic TI system. But before we move any further, we have to understand how the magnetic momentum will affect the TI band structures. So actually, if you look at the simplified full band model of the TI surface state, we know that by introducing the perpendicular magnetic order, actually, of course, the time of symmetry will be broken. But good enough is that the band inversion, as long as this term is not that large, the band inversion is still valid. So the consequence will be that the linear dissipation is, linear metallic surface state will just be reduced to a massive state with a surface will open a surface gap. So experimentally, we found that to dope the chromium into the TI turned out to be a very effective way to introduce the robust ferromagnetic order. As you can see from this picture, the chromium has been like distributed uniformly inside the entire host TI film, and the solubility of such dopants can be as high as 30% without introducing any secondary phase. So this is a huge difference from conventional dilute magnetic semiconductors. And most importantly, we found that the magnetic anisotropy is always perpendicular in such system, regardless of the film thickness. So all these salient features finally enable us to observe the quantum Lomsdorff effect, which I'll describe in the following. So first, from any classic quantum physics, we know that once there's a strong perpendicular magnetic field added on a 2D, two-dimensional system. And if this system has a relatively high carrier mobility, then the result will be the electron can only travel along the edge, because in the bulk, it's, the cyclotron the orbit will be closed. And this phenomenon is called quantum hole. And also, in the quantum hole state, the electron will travel along the edge without any power dissipation. But because for quantum hole, there's a requirement that we have always need to apply a magnetic field, so which makes the quantum hole not practical for any daily applications. So alternatively, people just think that how about we replace the external magnetic field with some internal magnetic momentum? And in such way, we can also realize the dissipationless H conduction, also the chiral H conduction, without power dissipation. And after decades of searching for such so-called long zero chain insulator, so just recent years, several groups has managed to prepare such system which can enable us to realize the quantum wormhole solve. So in our experiment, we just first grow a 10 quantum layer magnetic TI, and the layer thickness has been carefully verified through the TM as the experiment. And then we found that by cooling our samples down to 85 millikelvin, the vertical, it's a Hall resistance, has become quantized to H over E square. And in the meanwhile, if we look at the longitudinal resistance, it drops almost to zero at zero magnetic field, so which shows a clear signature of the dissipationless conduction. And by applying additional external magnetic field, we were able to sweep the magnetization of the same field. And you can see the quantized RxY changes sign. And the sign has been very consistent with the chiral H conduction plateau, which I show here. And one thing I have to emphasize that just similar to quantum hole, because for quantum anomalous hole, the time and resource symmetry is broken. So it's a chiral conduction. It's quite robust to any perturbation. So we do not need to care about any like the deface decoherent center. So this actually phenomenon has been realized in our miniature size device. So this is a really a macroscopic dissipationless conduction. And if we further reduce our magnetic TI thin film, so the bulk conduction is further minimized, we can realize the quantum anomalous hole at a relatively higher temperature. And interestingly, we found that the RxH with respect to the external magnetic field shows experience a huge change from almost zero to more than 200 megaohm. So in terms of MR, I think this is the largest MR ever identified in the semiconductor system. And also, if we replot the data in the conductance plot, we found it very interestingly that in addition to this two stabilized quantized state, there developed a very interesting zero hole plateau during the magnetization transition. And correspondingly, the longitudinal conductance has reached zero. So if we plot the conducting plot in the, we'll see that this quantum phase transition has continuously linked these two quantized levels to the insulating state. So this is shows the so-called the metal to insulator quantum phase transition in the quantum anomalous hole regime. Okay, so in order to understand the presence of the zero hole plateau in the two-dimensional quantum anomalous hole state, we recognize that in addition to the surface gap which caused by the magnetic exchange coupling, there will also be a hybridization between the top and the bottom surface, which will give rise to another surface gap. And the most importantly, because these two gaps actually has different signs, so which means that if we properly adjust their like strengths, we may change the chain number of the system from non-zero to zero. So which means that for the zero hole plateau state, actually, because the external magnetic field is reduced to around the cross-safety field, which means that the exchange gap is minimized. So the whole system is governed just by a normal gap, and the system actually will look like a multi-domain structure. And of course, since our previous 10 quantum sample, we don't have the hybridization. So actually, we do not, in those sample, we do not care about the chain number change. So in that case, we do not have the zero hole plateau. So this has been verified from our experiment data. So far, we only discussed about the uniform the magnetic chain system, and then I'll show you some of our work of the its related halo structures. So first of all, since we are doing the MB growth, so it's quite convenient for us to prepare. The TI and the chrome TI binary structure. So why we do this? Because conventionally, people found that if we combine the heavy metal with some metal, with some ferromagnetic metal, and this binary structure, the spin hole effect or the interfacial rushback effect can generate a spin hole current, and such spin current will, once injected into the ferromagnetic layer, will cause the magnetic leaching. So compared with the left hand side binder structure, actually our binder structure, the TI layer can be used as a heavy metal layer because it has even larger spin hole coupling, and the chromium doped TI will provide the magnetization. So experimentally, we did the such kind of experiment, and we demonstrate the current induced magnetization switching in our binder system. And more importantly, if we compare our result with the conventional metal-based system, we will see that the switching current density has been reduced to more than 3 orders of magnitude. This is not surprising because our TI has the largest SOC compared with the heavy metal. But I have to say that so far all the system has, regarding the magnetic TI, has been observed at low temperature. This is mainly because the pure temperature of the magnetic TI is relatively low. So one way to enhance the magnetic ordering temperature is to increase the doping, right? And indeed, some people have tried to heavily dope the TI to achieve around like 200 Kelvin TC system. But this strategy inevitably will degrade the sample quality. And if we dope the system with too much magnetic order dopants, the whole surface state may be eliminated. So alternatively, our strategy is trying to integrate the TI with some high temperature ferromagnetic and anti-ferromagnetic system. And by adopting the magnetic proximity that we are able to introduce the high temperature magnetic order into the TI system. And because there are already a variety of mature candidates that can be used for this purpose. So we think this may provide us with more possibility to realize the TI-related applications towards room temperature. So as for one example, recently we just trying to combine one type of anti-ferromagnetic material, which is chromium antimony, with our magnetic TI. And by doing MBE, we can produce all type of metal structures. Just to make sure that for each interface it's automatically sharp. That's a must-have condition. And then after the sample growth, we just study the magnetic behavior. So as compared to the single layer control sample, first the binder sample clearly show the so-called exchange bias effect, which means that the magnetic hysteresis loop will have a lateral shift. This is because at the interface, there will be some spin polarized the charge, which will kind of pin the polarization. So this is called the exchange bias effect. And if we turns into the trilayer structure, so depending on how we stack these two layers, we may have either the increase of the proximity field or the symmetric doubles the switching behavior in the trilayer system. So in this way, we demonstrate that by engineering the Z-Mac energy and the exchange energy, we are able to tailor the magnetic exchange coupling in our system. So furthermore, if we continuously stack these two layers to form the superlattice, then we were able to increase the whole system, the Curie temperature from almost 30 Kelvin to almost 90 Kelvin. And in this way, we demonstrate how, by using the structural engineering, we can change the system to a high temperature hard magnet. And finally, there's some of our more recent study, because the recent theoretical guys say that if we combine the magnetic TI with some superconductor system and in some critical point, we may realize the so-called the chiral topological superconductor with the odd log integral chain number Majorana H mode. So in our experiment, actually, we successfully combined the quantum anomalous hole state with some robust superconductor materials, and indeed we realized the chiral Majorana H mode by observing this significant half quantized plateau. So since due to the time limit, I will just do not, it's a bad this detail. If you want to be interested, you can look for this light script. Okay, so as a short conclusion, so since we are in the electrical engineering department, so our effort is trying to produce the high quality sample wafer scale. And all the phenomena I present here is quite reliable and with high repeatability. For example, all the sample, 90% of the sample we produce will have can reach quantum Lomsdorff state. And also, we are trying to push forward to make some practical devices. And finally, I want to end my talk by sharing with you a roadmap from our group. In the past few years, which we are to show our efforts to push forward the low dissipation spectronics applications. So that's, I think that's the end of my talk. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. We have 10 minutes to say something. Question, comment?
Okay, so I have a simple question about the quantum anomalous Hall effect and you show that in the film with a thickness of 6 quantum layer, you observe a plus at 0 fading factor. And could you turn to that slide? And this is only observable when you convert everything into conductance. And in the resistance plot, this 0 plateau is not clear. And
so actually, because you are talking about a very important question. Actually, if you look at the fundamental picture of the quantized transport, actually resistance is not a good number, because everything happens starts from the conduction, and since both the longitudinal conduction and the vertical conduction will take place in the quantized transport regime, so actually when we convert the conductance into resistance, actually for example Rxy contains the information from both the longitudinal conductance and the vertical conductance. So actually Rx6 and Rxy is not a good a parameter to describe the quantum transition. Actually, the whole picture scenario are also like described by quantum Hall guys like in 1990s. But
yeah.
The only difference is that at that time, the 2D EEG system, they don't have the zero number level, so they cannot reach the zero Hall plateau. But for this, and even for graphene, if you apply a very large field, you can realize the...
But I think in the case of graphene, you don't need to convert it to conductance, so in the resistance...
No,
for
graphene, if you look at, for example, Fitton King's PIO paper, they also like have only realized the plateau
in
the conductance plot instead of resistance plateau.
I see. Yeah. And the second short question also related to this topic. And after converting it to conductance, you see that the conductance are longitudinal conductance at the zero plateau is actually zero, but at plus one and minus one, it is a non-zero value. Do you have some comments about this?
Yeah, this is because for this system, actually as the quantum, you can clearly see that because there are some, I'll go back to this picture.
Mm-hmm.
Because when we do the measurements, you can see the Rx6 actually changed from very small value to very large value. And during this regime, actually we cannot stabilize the best temperature stay at 20 millikelvin or something.
Uh-huh.
So actually the temperature will change. Even like due to some like a constant sweeping speed, actually even at this point we cannot stabilize the temperature.
So
it makes some fluctuation.
So okay. It's the temperature instability.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. But if you look at this system, because at the 10 quantum layer sample, the peak of Rx6 is not that large.
Mm-hmm.
So actually the zero is very good. And actually our collaborator at Stanford recently just measured the same sample and they obtain only like 0.2 ohm. That's the system.
Okay.
More questions?
Very simple one. It's amazing you can dope chromium to 130% without breaking the TI state.
Mm-hmm. Actually for 30%, I just say for 30%, we still have the single crystalline film, but I'm not sure whether the 30% will eliminate the surface state.
Oh, really?
So, for example, for our quantum horse study, actually, quantum horse study, the doping level is only like 10 or
10%.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Thank you very much.